Class 11 Business Studies, we are on chapter number 8, that is Business Finance, and we are doing the sources of various business finance. Already we completed retail earning, trade credit, commercial paper, factoring, lease financing, all we completed already. Now today we are going to do the different sources. Other sources like shares, debentures, etc. So in that part we will do that, and I am sure you will be able to understand through various and through various slides. So first today's topic is shares. See shares. And you should note down, I will explain you, but it's my request to you, you have to note down because these slides are in a very easy language, so you will be able to understand what I am going to explain you. See, one by one, I will explain. Note down. Note down, please. Yes. Issue of shares is the easiest way for collecting sources of finance because for a public company, they can collect money from the common public easily without any problem. Those companies who are registered and public company, they have powers to issue the shares to the common public. Now see on the screen. The capital of a company is divided into a large number of equal parts or units. Each such unit is called shares. That's why it is known as share capital. Because the whole capital is divided in small units and each unit is known as share. In other words, share is the share in the share capital. Or share is the unit of the share capital. Share is the part of total whole share capital. The aggregate value of shares is known as share capital. See, look at the board. Complete, this is completely known as share capital, but it is divided in various parts, and each part will be known as unit of it, and each part is share. So, the part or the unit or the share of the share capital is known as share. Okay, so these are the shares. So share capital is divided in various parts, that's why it is known as share. Those who subscribe to share capital become the members of the company. They are also known as shareholders. They are also got the status of owners in the company. That's why it is known as ownership securities. Again, I am telling you. See, share, if you get the share of any company, you will become the member of that company and you are also known as shareholder. Whether one share or 1,000 shares, you are having a share, that's why you are known as shareholders. And they are getting the status of owners in the company. Shares are also described as ownership securities. Two types of shares can be issued by the companies. Look at the screen. There are two types of shares a company can issue. Shares are classified in two types, equity shares and preference shares. Equity shares and preference shares are the two types a company can issue. In India, equity share is the only one variety, but different shares are classified in various varieties, which I will explain you. Redeemable, irredeemable, convertible, non-convertible, all are there. I will give you the detail for that. So, but first of all, what is share? Share is the part of share capital. What is share capital? Company is divided its capital into various parts. As I told you, some are own sources, some are borrowed sources. Some are internal, some are external. So on that, the total investment is known as capital. And the capital invested through shares are known as share capital. And the part of share capital is known as share. And those who are having the shares are known as shareholders. Okay? Shareholders are the real owners of the company. They are known as shareholders or the members of the company. They are described as ownership securities. Company can issue two types of shares. One is ES, equity shares. Another is preference shares, PS. Okay, got it? Now see. Equity shares. Shares are of two types. Equity shares are known as ordinary shares. See, ordinary shares means those shares which don't carry any special or preferential right. See, in preference shares, it is easy. Preference, they have preference. But equity shares don't have any preference. Okay, clear? They don't have any special right, any preferential right for dividend or capital. Equity shareholders are the risk bearer, but they are known as real people. Real owners of the company. They have right to attend meetings. They can give vote in the meetings. They receive any money only after the payment of all other debts. So the amount raised by the issue of equity share is known as equity share capital. It's easy. The company collected funds by the issue of equity shares. They are known as equity share capital. Now, what are the merits for equity shares? Suitable for risk takers. Those investors who are ready to take risk can invest in it. No obligation for dividend. If the company is having profits, then they will get the dividend. Otherwise, there is no risk, no responsibility, no burden of dividend. See, dividend means the amount or the income or the return by the company to the investors for their investment in shares. Clear? So, the no obligation for dividend. That is the major benefit of equity shares, that company don't have burden to pay the dividend compulsory. Because at the end, if the company is having profits, they will give it to the shareholders. Otherwise, no need to give, no responsibility. But in case I will compare it with other modes, then you will be able to understand that like debentures, companies has to compulsory pay the interest. Same on bank loan, but in equity shares, it's very easy for a company. No need to pay the dividend. If you don't have profit, don't give. Then it is permanent source of capital. When a company issues equity shares, that will be not refunded back in the lifetime of the company. If the company will wind up that business in the future, that time they will save, they will have capital, they will return. Sufficient amount they will return, otherwise there is no need. So this is permanent source of capital. no need to return, no liability to return. That's why it is not as a temporary source that after 5 years or 10 years company have to repay it. No, it is a permanent capital source. Then it provides creditworthiness to the company, means reputation of the company. Just now, if your parents ask where to invest, what you will say? What will you say, beta? Yes, you will say those companies, those who are reputed, having good reputation in the market, having goodwill, those companies who are credit worthy, we should invest in them. Why? Because they will return you your money. Then no charge against asset. That point yesterday also I explained you, no charge against asset means there is no risk, no paperwork, no guarantee, mortgage, hypothecation against any asset. Means company will not keep their asset as guarantee in somewhere else. See, if the company will take the loan from the bank, they have to give some guarantee, some mortgage, some hypothecation. But in that case, in the shares, there is no need to keep any guarantee. So the assets are not under charge. They have voting rights. Voting right means companies follow democratic management. Democratic management means every shareholder, each and every shareholder has a right to give their opinion. What do you understand by democratic? Yes, we say in the history or in other subjects you have studied that India is a democratic country. What does it mean? Yes. It means everyone has right to give vote, express their opinion. They can select their government. Same here in the shareholders, they can give their votes in annual general meeting. They can attend the meetings. They can give votes. They can select their directors. So generally company follows democratic management. And by the opinion of the shareholders, because shareholders are the real owners of the company. So company follow democratic management. Now, as I told you, everywhere there is some limitations also. So limitation is income is not steady from the point of view of investors, shareholders. Fluctuations are there because dividend is based on profits. If the company is earning high profits, company will give the shareholders high profit, high dividend. Dividend is based on the profits of the company. If the company is earning high profit, they will give the. If the company is having loss, they will not give the dividend. If the company is having less profits, they will declare less dividend. High cost. What is the meaning of cost here? Yesterday I explained flotation cost. Cost of equity. It is very high because it is not easy to issue the equity shares in the market. First of all, company has to register it, take the permission of SEBI. Okay, you will study about that in class 12. Then they appoint some underwriters. Then they issue prospectus also. So that will be the lengthy process as well as costly process. Then dilution and control for existing shareholders when the company makes fractional issues. Dilution and control for existing shareholders when the company makes fresh issues, it means when the company add up more investors, they also have voting rights. So when there are very many members in the meeting for giving their opinion or for their voting, exercising their voting rights, everyone will have different opinion. So the control may be divided. Some want some other directors, some want some other directors. There will be disputes. There will be conflicts. The control will be diluted. Okay. Then complex legal formalities. It is very difficult to collect the money from the public through equity shares because the company has to fulfill various legal formalities. Incorporation, registration, all are required. Now the next topic is preference shares. Preference shares. Preference shares, as in the mention in the name only, this is the another type of shares, that is preference shares. Preference share is one which carries certain preferential rights with regards, they have preference, preferential rights with regard to the payment of dividend at a fixed rate during the continuance of the company and repayment of capital on the winding up of the company. So generally, preference shareholders, that's why they keep that name, preference. Two preferences they have. One is they get the dividend at a fixed rate, okay, and another, if the company is going to wind up, they have preference to get back their money back. The company first preference will give to preference shareholders. Then, if the amount remaining, then they give to equity shareholders. Otherwise, first of all, they will give to preference shareholders. If the amount remaining, then equity shareholders will get. Capital raised by issue of preference share is called preference share capital, and the holders are known as preference shareholders. Preference shares is the part of preference share capital. Okay. Now, what are the privileges? You can ask, why then people prefer preference shares, why not equity shares? Because preference share holders have some preferences, like they right to get the dividend first at a fixed rate before it is given to the equity shareholders. Means when the company is having profits, first they will give dividend to the preference shareholders. If the amount remaining, then they will give it to the equity shareholders. That's why they have privilege. Second, preference shareholders' right to get the repayment of capital on winding up of the company. If the company is going to wind up, first of all, they will pay to the preference shareholders. If that amount is remaining, then they pay to the equity shareholders. So, preference shareholders have the preference in two types, at the time of getting dividend and at the time of wind up of the company. The company will repay them. Then what is the benefit of equity shares? See children, see the world, they get the dividend at a fixed rate. This is the benefit we can get in preference share only, because in equity shares, the residual profit, remaining all whole profit will be given to equity shareholders. Okay, that is the reason. Now, see the merits. Merits of preference share is they get the fixed rate of return is guaranteed. Means if you invest in preference share, some amount of dividend you will get, guaranteed company will give. preference in repayment of capital on winding up when the company is going to close their business, shut down their business, they are going on wind up process, they first pay to preference shareholders. Then no dilution in control, because company will not call the preference shareholders in the meeting. They will not call them. That's why they call only equity shareholders. That's why equity shareholders are the real owners than trading on equity. Trading on equity means equity shareholders enjoy more return in good times. As I told you, that preference shareholders will get fixed rate, but the remaining amount equity shareholders will enjoy. Then no charge over the asset. No charge over the asset. I already explained you in other points that the assets are need not to be given as mortgage. Economical. Cost of raising preference share is cheaper than the equity capital, because equity capital requires more legal formalities. Then demerits. Demerits are reasons not suitable for high risk takers. Preference shareholders are never suitable for those who can take risk, because they have fixed rate of interest, not extra. Dilutes claim on asset. When the company will share the assets, that time there will be some dilutes. High rate of dividend. This is from the point of view of company. Generally, company provides high rate of dividend than the interest rate of debentures. So the debenture holders will face the loss at that time, because the company will give high rate of dividend to preference shares. It may not attract many investors. See, many investors are there, those who are not ready to invest in the preference share. Those who are taking or ready to take risk, because they want more dividends, so they attract towards equity shares. And no tax benefit. This is also a drawback in Indian concern. We can say that we are investing in preference shareholders, but the income received on preference shares, which is known as dividend received on preference shares, will not give you tax benefits. That is taxable income, not deductible income. That's why many people don't prefer to get by these preference shares, because they don't get benefit of tax. That is not deductible amount, that is taxable amount. But they want to invest in some other where they want to get the tax benefits. Okay, so they will not invest. Those who want to get more tax benefits, they will invest in some other, like the ventures, which I will explain to you tomorrow. Okay, so today what we discuss is, I'll explain you one by one. We start from yesterday. We completed like commercial paper and see the issue of shares. Shares are the part of share capital, and the aggregate value is known as share capital. They are known as the members of the company. They are known as shareholders. They are known as the owners of the company. That's why it is known as own sources. Yes. Do you know about that? Own sources and borrowed sources. Yes. On the basis of ownership. Now, two types of shares can be issued by the company. Equity shares and preference shares. Equity shares are known as ordinary shares, because they are not like preference shares. So today we discuss, see the screen, sources of business finance. The total amount invested is known as share capital, and the part of each is known as share. Share is of two types, equity shares and different shares. Equity shares and different shares we can differentiate also. Equity shares holders are known as the real owners of the company because they have right to attend meeting. They can give voting. Remaining amount they will get, but that is not sure that the company will give them dividend. If they have profits, they will give the dividend. If they don't have profits, they will not give dividend on equity shareholders. Okay, that's why they are known as residual owners. Now come on to the preference shareholders. As in the name given, preference shareholders are having preference to get the dividend, means part of income, and at the time of when the company will be close their business, they will get their money back before equity shares. So they have preference in two types: in getting dividend and at the time of wind up, company will return to preference shareholders first, then they will return to equity shareholders. But preference shareholders don't have right to attend meetings. They don't have power to give their votes, but they will get only a fixed amount of dividend. Those who are ready to take risk will invest in equity shares because the residual amount, the remaining amount, company will give as dividend. Okay? Any doubt?